These two rails are the new equipments which are going to be in the market by the end of 2019. I present to you the agricultural drone and the combined harvester. Let me introduce you to the agricultural drone. Bohai, a private company, along with the collaboration of the Indian government, has created this unique machine known as the agricultural drone, which is still in the concept phase. It will be in the markets by 2019. So this drone can capacitate a total of 40 lakh liters of water, which is enough to irrigate 10 acres of land without any refueling. And farmers are being trained so that they get used to it and to handle this sort of equipment well. We move on to the combined harvester. The work of a harvester is to harvest, and the work of a combined harvester is to harvest as well as segregate. We take an example of the vegetables which are produced under the surface of the earth. Example, carrots and potatoes. Let's take carrots. The harvester will harvest the carrots and then segregate it to the vegetable part and the leafy part. So the leafy part will go in a separate bin and the vegetable part in a different one. So this is how the work of the farmers will get reduced in a lot easier way. Now we move on to the next sector, which is the processing sector. The government is planning to give employment to 1.22 million people. The government is planning to give employment to 100 million people by the end of 2019 in the processing sector. This will help in increasing the GDP of the country, as well as it will increase in the income of the middle class group in the country. The government has even agreed to give power and money in developing the branded commodities which are in trend. Now let me introduce you to the technological aspect in this sector. It is the cold plasma. All of us eat strawberries, and as soon as we consume it, we leave it for some time and it gets spoiled, but not with the cold plasma. The cold plasma, soon after plucking the strawberries, is put in the cold plasma. With high pressure, the cold plasma cleans the dirt off the strawberries, and using plasma, it is increasing the shelf life of the strawberries. So no need to worry. Eat and leave and forget, then eat again. It's no issues with the continuous plasma. Now we move on to the software sector. I believe all of us love applications and software, but do you know about the NOFIN, the National Optical Fiber Network, which is started by the government of India? It has been laid to connect 250,000 gram panchayats, zilla parishads, and all the other sort of codes in India. This is a private network from the Indian government with no intrusions. The normal public uses a separate sort of internet, while this sector will use a separate one. So there will be no bias in judging. And then let me introduce you to SMAC. A SMAC is a business software. Indian government is training people, 150,000 people, to develop the SMAC software. The SMAC software, along with the government of India, will help business ventures. It'll help the business to connect with their consumers in a much different way. Now we move on to the fourth sector, which is the textile sector. As per the statement made by the government of India, 27,65,000 people are being trained to do their miracles in this sector. The Central Board of Sericulture in India, which is located in Bangalore, is using chemicals to produce hybrid silkworms. This will give higher quality of silk, and which will increase the quality of silk production in India. Now, I'll tell you about the Kalimat Dupa and the roll concept. This is another sort of machine which is still in concept. The manufacturing has started, but it will take some time to manufacture this great invention. The main capacity of this is that it can do work of 5 machines in one. So you need to worry about picking up materials and putting it in different machines. Put it in this, and then you can have the end product in a matter of just 15 minutes. This helps in the increase in production and is less time consuming. Now let's go on to the last sector, which is the transport sector. All of us have been to railway stations and we know about the development in these. So the Indian government promises to increase the level of the railways to a new standard. It promises to make international standards in railways. Now they are going to provide all facilities which a passenger needs in the railway stations. The NHAI, the National Highway Authorities of India, have planned to lay down 60,000 km highways in India, which is going to facilitate road trade in a better way. Even in the ports, it's merely 55 metric tons, but it's really very less. So by the end of 2019, the government promises you an increase of 8,800 billion metric tons. This is going to be more than any other country in the world. Even US has merely 752 metric tons, million. This is a rapid change in the Indian development and in sectors of India. I'll introduce you to flight style trains. All of us have been on flights and trains. So trains are really they give you less privacy and plus they are really very slow. So these flight style trains promise you to reach your destination in a really less time and will give you all the amenities that a flight provides you. Not only that, it will even provide you 24/7 Wi-Fi. Who needs anything else? And now we come to the end of this seminar, and let us all join our hands and make India a superpower of the world. Thank you and Jai Hind.
A very interesting presentation. Thank you both of you. We know India is progressing so much, but still where are we lacking in promoting our Swadesh goods? Still people go for foreign goods. Where are we lacking in promoting our Swadesh commodities?
The mindsets of people vary. Indian government, as I said, is creating 27,65,000 people to improve the silk and the handloom handicraft as well as the Indian cotton production. So by the end of 2019, it will be a varied production as Indian handicraft and Indian production sector of the of handloom and clothes material will be in a 75% to a 25% with the British and the foreigner goods.
You spoke about the different type of technologies, right? The flight style train and what was that, the drone you were speaking about?
Agricultural
drone. And the different technologies you were speaking about introducing in the agriculture sector to increase the shelf life of certain things.
Yes, ma'am.
How feasible is it keeping the social evils in India like poverty, illiteracy? How feasible is it, even if such a technology comes up, how is it going to be feasible for a poor man or a middle class income person? How is it going to benefit?
Now in these type of trains, not only one or two people travel, there will be a million of people. So the more the volume, the cost will also become less. Like now how the railway train, how the Indian trains now run. There are a lot of people and a large number of volume of people who travel. That's why the ticket costs are very less. Now if it is like only 10 or 15 people who would opt for train services, then even the current train ticket prices would be really high.
Agricultural drone also, the farmers, how do you think they can take up this kind of technology? Do you think there should be a change in laws?
Ma'am, first of all, I'd like to inform that the agricultural drone is not going to be commercialized and is not going to be bought by people. It is going to stay under the control of the government who is going to supply water to all to 25% of the fields which have been selected by the government, and especially they are concentrating on the fields of Punjab and Tamil Nadu, which are the highest state of production in India. And then in 2018, this agricultural drone is going to be tested in the states of Punjab and Tamil Nadu. And only if this idea is feasible, if it is effective, then is it going to be commercialized, but it cannot be bought by the people. India will be manufacturing more of these and will be helping the people
farmers.
We'll be helping the farmers.
Well said.
Thank you.